Welcome back to How to Write Your Novel in 9 Weeks. It's week four, day three, and today's topic is how much research is too much research. It would probably surprise you that some novelists, whose plots span not just generations but eons, are their own research department. They want their books to begin at the beginning. If not the beginning of time, then perhaps the beginning of the shaping of the continents or the foundation of a culture that's thousands and thousands of years old. One would hope they like researching.
On the other hand, there are some novelists who know they have to get some facts right. Boston in the east, Los Angeles in the west. Nothing about London here? Nothing about the Thames? Nothing? All right. But don't care much about the minor stuff. And since it's their books, they get to decide what's minor.
They don't need to know the latest slang being used by teenagers, even if they have a teen using slang. They don't need to know the bookstore is next to the peep show place in a seedy part of the city, even though they're going to have a scene or two in that part of town.
They're going to what? Oh, I don't know. Who's writing that?
It's a scene. Like a scene could take place, you know, in a less than desirable part of town.
Part of town? You're starting to talk like me now. Bill, there is hope for you. Not much, but there is hope, and hope is a wonderful thing.
Fiction is fiction. And your readers, God bless them, will accept the world that you create and the rules you create to govern that world. In each genre, in every genre, they will accept your novel as a member of that genre as long as you follow the basic guidelines for that type of novel.
I think they know that. They know what kind of novel they like to read, and they know what can and can't happen in a novel like that. So if, dear author, dear novelist, if you follow the guidelines, you'll be fine. And doing a little creative writing within the guidelines, that's all right too.
I'll give you an example. Much of my book, Pope Bob, takes place in downtown Seattle. From the time I began writing it until the time it was published, a lot of that part of the city had changed. That was okay. I can say the library is here and the Catholic Cathedral is there, and they still are. But this particular tavern or restaurant on this particular corner may now be an upscale coffee shop or a graveled parking lot. This street, which was two-way, may now be only one-way, and on and on. I feel safe saying, if you try to be as accurate as possible in all the details, you will never get your manuscript completed. Make a mistake that a sharp-eyed reader will take delight in pointing out to you. Or be dismayed to discover that as the world and all that's in it keep changing, whatever was correct when you wrote the manuscript has now become incorrect. I'll give you another example. When I began Pope Bob, telephone booths were common. By the time I had it finally ready for publication, cell phones had all but eliminated them.
Again, some details matter to the reader, and so need to matter to you as a writer. Don't confuse, well, this is more American stuff here, isn't it, really? Don't confuse President Washington with President Lincoln. Well, what if we said, don't confuse King George with...
With who?
With whom, Bill? With Queen Elizabeth. Oh, that would be confusing. I don't think you... Anyway.
Don't put Des Moines in Ohio or Boise in Iowa.
Oh, that's one of those. Iowa, Idaho, Ohio, they're all the same, aren't they? They're sort of in the middle. They're those middle things. Nobody really cares about the middle, Bill. Where are you from, Bill?
Iowa.
Oh. Well, that's wonderful. That's wonderful. I think I had a cousin in Columbus, Iowa, or maybe it was Cincinnati.
Moving on. Don't have New Orleans on Eastern time, or let water come to a boil at 200 degrees Fahrenheit.
Fahrenheit? Who are you? Oh, the states, the colonists. They still do that, don't they?
And other details don't matter if you don't want them to. Who cares if really it was sunny or rainy in New York City on July 4th, 1998? If you find out it was sunny and your plot needs it rainy, let it rain. But there are some dates and places you can't mess around with. Readers would have a hard time believing your New Yorker spent an uneventful day in Manhattan on September 11th, 2001.
As you write your manuscript, don't get sidetracked with details. If you want to go back and check something, jot down a quick note to yourself, but keep writing to make that day's word count.
When I began writing fiction, it was harder to check facts. You had to go to the library, find a reliable source, check out a book. Nowadays, it's much, much easier, but it's also much, much easier to get distracted.
Don't confuse writing with researching. Your writing may need some researching, but not while you're writing your daily word count. And tomorrow, let's wrap this up, Bill. You got a little wordy today. You did. I think you kind of wandered about. Tomorrow, I'm going to talk about why writers write, and it's going to be spectacular.